How do I close my Hotmail or Outlook.com account? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a very common question. I need to close my Hotmail account. I'm getting too much spam, and besides, I think it's been hacked. I just want to close it and stop it from bothering anyone anymore. How do I do that? Well, I want you to reconsider. First, I will tell you how to close it, but I want to make sure that you understand what will and will not happen if you do. Closing your account will not stop spam that looks like it came from your account. Closing your account will not stop your contacts from being bothered. Closing your account will not guarantee that emails sent to it will bounce. Closing your account may not even be possible if you don't have access to the account yourself. Closing your account may prevent you from signing into your PC if you're using it as your Microsoft account for that PC. So, with that out of the way, let's close the account. One of the very first scenarios where people actually ask this question is when they've had their account hacked and they don't have access to the account. I'm sorry, but you can't close the account if you don't have access to it. Think about it. You have to prove you're the rightful owner of the account. Otherwise, anybody could close any account at any time. What you want to do instead is attempt to recover the account. That will basically go through the steps of proving that you are the rightful owner. In addition then to regaining access to the account, you'll be able to close it if you still want to. But if you can't sign into the account, you cannot close the account. That's the way it is. So, closing the account. Let's do that. I'm going to go through the steps here on my Windows 11 machine with Outlook.com. I want to be clear that these are the steps as they are today. Outlook.com obviously goes through a lot of changes over time, but these are the steps as they are today. You may need to be a little flexible in finding the same kinds of things should things change in the future. This is Outlook.com online. So we've signed in to our online Outlook.com email account. Now we'll click on our profile picture, or if you don't have a profile picture set, there'll be a couple of letters up here related to your name. Click on My Microsoft Account. Click on Your Info, and then scroll down until you find Close Account. So, sure enough, there's a Close Account button. We'll click on that. Now they're going to ask us to sign in again to prove that we are the rightful account holder. Now, this page is important, and I also have it included in the companion article for this video at askleo.com/12379. This is telling you all of the ramifications of closing your account. You may not want to if these are going to impact you. Only when you are certain that all of this is okay do you want to hit next. Now, I'm not going to, because in reality, I don't want to close this account. But the process from here on out will take you through the steps of actually closing the account. Notice that there is this 60 days reopen window, is what I call it. Basically, they understand that it is very possible for people to close their account without truly realizing the ramifications. That gives them 30 or 60 days, I recommend 60, to change your mind. If you change your mind, simply sign into the account again and it'll reopen. But I recommend you make this window as large as is available. It is very, very common to change your mind. Now, alternatives. Well, remember, of course, that if you can't sign into your account, it's not your account anymore. Your only alternative is to create a new account and get on with your life. If you have access to the account, or you need to keep access to the account, then you can simply ignore email sent to the account. Keep the account active, sign into it once in a while, but ignore anything that's sent to it. I actually don't recommend you do this because you might be getting important messages about the services associated with the account, the services that caused you to not want to close the account after all. So what I recommend you do instead is secure the account as best you can, including all of your alternative information, all of the account recovery information, and so on, and then start managing your spam. Just start marking your spam as spam and getting on with your life using the account normally. But if you still want to close the account and you understand all of the ramifications of doing so, well, now you know how. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/12379. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.